That deer just got fucking smoked by that bus. Like, holy fucking shit, dude. I guess that answers the age-old question, why did the deer cross the road? Well, to get hit by a fucking bus, dude. Holy shit. That kid almost had his fucking pumpkin, boom, crushed. It's fucking nuts. Holy shit. Anyway, I'm your host, as always, James Brindle. We got some lovely articles for you again today, as we usually fucking do. Oh my God. So, Kevin Spacey. He's back in the news. But not for what you think it is, but kind of for what you think it is. He's going to be starring in a movie. I don't want to give too much up. I'll let the article explain it. It's more pedophile shit, if you can believe it. I mean, at this point, like, everything's believable. But anyway, let's get in this fucking article. I got another one for you right after this. Fuck, I'm excited. Yes, let's do this. Yes! Fuck a deer!
Actor Kevin Spacey is reportedly making his return to Hollywood in a role where he plays a detective investigating a man wrongly accused of being a pedophile. Oh, this is so good. So good. Spacey will play a police officer investigating the case of a man who is accused of being a child molester. I mean, I guess he's ready for that role, isn't he? I am very happy Kevin agreed to participate in my film, director Frank Nero told ABC News. I consider him a great actor and I can't wait to start this movie. The film will also feature Nero's wife, Vanessa Redgrave, who will play the accused man's piano teacher. Oh man, can't wait for this one to launch up. In 2017, Ari Ben, I think that's how you pronounce that, accused Spacey of sexual misconduct. He claimed that Spacey groped his genitals under a table after the 2007 Nobel Peace Prize concert in Oslo. He committed suicide in 2019. Aw, that's sad. Ben was one of more than a dozen who stepped forward to accuse Spacey of misconduct. Ben was the second alleged victim of Spacey's to die. In September of that year, an anonymous massage therapist who sued Spacey for alleged sexual misconduct, assaulting him during a session in 2016, also died. Little spooky? Maybe a coincidence? Maybe the Spacey Force. In 2018, Kevin Spacey returns as Frank Underwood, in a way, to rebuke numerous sexual assault allegations in a short film called Let Me Be Frank. We've covered this before on the episode of Degenerates. I think it's number 5, something like that. Very freaky stuff. I love it. I think it's like top notch. I'm looking at IMDb right now, and it's 7.0 out of 10. Like, I mean, that's amazing. The video Kevin Spacey posted on Christmas Eve has been repeatedly described as bizarre, and for good reason, because no one really knows what it means. It's cryptic. Wearing a Santa apron and occasionally sipping from a mug, Spacey seems to inhabit his House of Cards character, Frank Underwood. We have actually dissected this video once before on episode number 5 of the Degenerates Variety Show, where me, Blasto Hard Cheese, and Mad Stacks tore this one apart. Making some jokes, kind of getting scared. We thought maybe we'd be on the Spacey watch list after that, you know, the Spacey Force. But I think I'm going to give this movie a shot. I'm going to put the preview for you here real quick and you tell me what you think, but I still think this man deserves another shot. I think Louis C.K. deserves another shot. And I still think Tony Hinchcliffe, even though he's in the midst of this, yeah, don't shut him off yet. Freedom of speech, man. You should be able to laugh. Maybe not rape people, but you should be able to laugh. Anyway, back to you.
The next time someone does something you don't like, you can go on the attack, but you can also hold your fire. And do the unexpected. You can kill them with kindness.
Yeah, it's still creepy. Yeah, that's still fucked up. I said there's gonna be a preview, but I couldn't find a preview. I jumped the gun on that one, and I'm sorry. There's no preview for that. Anyway, moving on swiftly to our next article. Florida! Fuck yeah, give it up for Florida. You know you love it. I'm sure that's where you guys are from. Like, I don't even know how you got here. But straight up, you're fucking from Florida. I'm sick of your shit. Anyway, the Invincible Florida Man. This guy just can't seem to die. He's been struck by lightning. This motherfucker, like, I'm surprised he hasn't got eaten by an alligator and shit out just to get stomped on by, is there a horse? Some kind of like fucking wild horse in Florida? No, I didn't think so. But anyway, without further ado, let's get on to our next article, Florida! Enjoy.
A Florida man who says he survived a lightning strike, a rattlesnake bite, and two separate monkey attacks is now recovering in a Tampa hospital after he was bitten by a shark in the Bahamas. I just want to say, I'm really glad we're doing this Florida episode. I gotta say, shout out to Lindsay Griffin for helping me put this one together. This was a great idea. Let's keep rolling. Eric Norrie took his first small steps at a Tampa General Hospital on Sunday, nearly a week after a shark tore a hunk from his left leg during attack in the Abaco Islands. Abaco Islands? Fuck, I've never heard of it. Norrie, who owns a company that makes paint for boats, had been spearfishing for grouper off the Great Guanacay and was swimming back to his family aboard their 33-foot Hydrosport, whatever the fuck that is, when he was struck by the predator. He goes on to say, I just felt this tremendous power hit my leg. When I looked back, I saw a shark ripping the side of my leg off. He was like, shaking his head and like, fucking eating it. The 40-year-old Largo resident managed to shake off the shark and hobble to a sandbar, where he fashioned an old school tourniquet below his knee using part of his Hawaiian sling spear. His daughter radioed for help, and a doctor and her family who were boating nearby sped over and helped him get ashore. After the doctors at local Marsh Harbor Hospital stabilized him, Norrie was flown by helicopter to Jackson Memorial Hospital in Miami, where he underwent surgery. Yo, best place to undergo surgery, right? Miami? Am I right? Am I right? On Wednesdays, doctors at Tampa General are scheduled to take two hunks of flesh from his thigh and graft them onto his calf. Recovery will take months. Yeah, it takes a while. Norrie says he's in pain, but thankful to be alive. Well, you know, what happens to him next? Jesus Christ. Hold on to your pants. It wasn't the Florida native's first extreme brush with Mother Nature, or his second, or even his third. As a 10-year-old, he was blown off his feet, but unhurt when an oak tree he was standing under got hit by a bolt of lightning during a storm. Some 3 years later, he spent 2 weeks in intensive care and nearly lost his right leg after a rattlesnake bit him while he was walking with some pals through a local country club. He's been attacked by monkeys. Twice. Like, I'm talking twice. But neither of those small brushes with death came anywhere close to that shark attack incident. Incident? Yeah. My God. Learn how to speak, James. The first Donkey Kong-sized monkey punch to his dome was when he was on a work trip to Brazil. He wandered too close to a monkey in the Amazon, resulting in a primate punch to the head. What kind of job do you have where you're just wandering through the Amazon and happen across a fucking monkey? Like, let's get real. Florida. The second was at a farm in Honduras when, as a joke, his wife locked him in a cage with a small, feisty simian. Norrie said the beast jumped on his head and chest, bit him, and pelted him with his own keys. Outside the cage, his wife was in no hurry to help. She just took photos and giggled. Oh my good God. We should really do some back, like, fact-checking and find out if, like, their kid was the one that got thrown in that cage. Because by the sound of his wife, you know, like, that's pretty sus. Back to you in the studio, man. Jesus fucking Christ.
Anyway, that's the show for tonight. Thanks for watching. If you like what you see, you know, do all those stupid YouTube things. I don't like saying it. It's so cliche and dumb. I hate it. And check out some of these other amazing videos on the network. Love ya. Mwah. Beer. Sip. Bye.